I think that dog-dog play is a really important topic. You know, we talk about things like separation anxiety and aggression, and these are the really serious things. But the truth is that dog-dog play can be a very serious thing, too. And any of you who have been to your local dog park might have seen that. Yeah, we're going to talk about dog parks. But my goal today in talking about dog-dog play is actually to go over what is some of the body language that we see in dog-dog communication in groups, and what are the things that we need to look out for, how can we look out for them, what are some danger signals, what constitutes healthy play, and then we're going to just kind of break it down into different aspects of play. And we did used to think that, for sure, that the dog play, the puppy play, was their instinctive way of rehearsing things that they were going to be doing later on, like hunting, for example, and fighting. And if you think about it, I think it may be that that's partly true, but if that was the reason, why does it stop when they're adults? Wouldn't they kind of need to brush up on that or keep it up? I don't know. You know, there's kind of on both sides of the fence about that theory now. And so, you know, if you see puppies in a litter playing and one bites down too hard, what does the other one do? They yelp. Right? They say, I'm not playing with you anymore. Thank you very much. So I am going to show you a video, and this is 3-week-old puppies playing. So, what kind of things did you see going on there? A lot of mouthing. What else? A lot of pawing. Leaning. Yeah. Biting. What else? Climbing. Yeah. And this is their second trip outdoors. These are huskies. And their mom is trying to, she's trying to coax the puppies to learn how to play. So what a great mom, you know? I totally agree. Yeah, and I think that one puppy was kind of like overwhelmed with what she was doing, and the other one was more like, I'll play, I can do this. Before we go on, I want to talk just a little bit about displacement behaviors, because this really plays into what we're talking about. Displacement behavior is basically a normal behavior that is occurring out of context. I want to talk about what constitutes healthy play. And so, What is healthy play? What should it look like in the best of all worlds? Well, we have friendly body language. What's friendly body language? What should it look like when the dogs are playing? Loose, good. Yeah, I want those bodies to be kind of limp and waggy and loose. Reciprocal, who said that? Yeah, and we're going to talk about reciprocal and how reciprocal does it have to be. Good, yeah. Sharing space, good. Yeah, one not kind of crowding the other one, right, and being okay. So I'm going to show you a video of what I mean by the self-handicapping. This is my neighbor's dog, by the way. The large pit bull is my neighbor's dog, and they found this puppy.
Very sweet.
So these dogs don't even know each other.
I don't get what they say about pit bulls. It's like, it's so fun.
Yeah, really big, scary.
She's a wonderful dog.
Oh my gosh, you're a big scary pit bull.
It's okay, it's totally play, that growl. It's nothing. My neighbors had called me over because they were very concerned that their pit bull was going to hurt the puppy that they were fostering. And this
totally
worried her.
Yeah.
No, this worried her. She's like, oh my God, I didn't mean it. I'm so sorry.
Right away. I wouldn't worry about
that. That was the puppy that yelped. this is a fabulous dog. Are you kidding? This is a dog I want all kinds of puppies to go over there to. Very, very, very tolerant of the puppy. Absolutely not going to hurt her. And that puppy, you know, not horribly obnoxious, but definitely getting, you know, I'll chew in your face. Yeah. So that is definitely self-handicapping. I want to talk about different play styles. Let's talk a little bit about play styles. Play styles can differ, obviously, from breed to breed. I'm starting to think that standard poodles all have springs in their feet. Because I'm telling you, all the ones that I see at the park anyway, they're vertical. I mean, this is their play style. And they can be really, really insistent. They can do a lot of this jumping on and off. They can do a lot of the nose bonking thing, you know, that you're talking about. And not every dog's like that, obviously. Some dogs are a little more like, I'll body slam you, or huskies. How many of you have northern breeds, huskies, malamutes, anybody? Just me, huh? And you. So, you know, a lot of what they'll do is they'll, like, jump on each other's backs and they'll grab, like, the ruff and the fur. And my dogs understand each other when they do that. But if a dog doesn't speak northern breed, it's like, wow, that was kind of dominant. What are you doing? What do you mean by that? Now, what can we look for that'll tell us, hey, there might be a problem here? I want to go on record as saying that nothing good ever started with a hard stare. I grew up in New York, and I can tell you from having ridden the subways that nothing good ever happens with a hard stare. So what are you looking at? A hard stare in the animal kingdom is a threat. I'm not saying they can't look at each other, but if there's really this hard stare, you know, what's going to come after that? And I'm going to show you a video of a German Shepherd and a boxer playing. And they're, I think, appropriate in their play. It's not really worrying me. But watch what happens when the... when another dog comes in. It's a little rough, but they're okay. That German Shepherd, by the way, is what I would call socially awkward. You couldn't tell really in this one. This was really good play for that dog. He's a dog that frequents the park often. And I'm going to show you the same one who the shepherd does a little chin over to this pit bull puppy, and the pit bull puppy gets stressed out by it. It's not just like, oh, I was just kidding. Okay, so you see the little lick there? Look at that look. Does the shepherd seem to get it? Let's talk about mounting. Okay. So, in dogs? Okay, so here's the thing. How many of you think that mounting is a problematic behavior between dogs? I've trained you too well, damn it. Yeah, I know, I'm going to get like a shirt that says, it depends. Okay, so yeah, I mean, and actually you're right. And the thing is, mounting can be a sexual behavior, obviously, between dogs, but it can also be a dominant behavior. Here's the thing, I think that we know when it's a sexual behavior, right, because it ends in the dogs being tied. But if it is truly a dominant behavior, that's one thing. And you'll know pretty quick because the other dog will really say, excuse me, you know, what are you doing? Excuse you. A lot of times in play, it's not even a dominant behavior. There are some dogs who will approach another dog that way to play because they're kind of socially dorky, you know? It's true. But I think that, again, it's all about context.